I'm gonna be like Marco Rubio and keep my water closed. I get dry mouth too. It's the medicine you take that makes your mouth so dry. Hallelujah. God is good.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Praise your Father.
Amen.
Praise your Father.
Amen.
You're so good to us. You know, years ago when I was young, God used to give me a lot of dreams and visions. And there was never once when God didn't bring it to pass, whatever He told me. He brings it to pass. If He tells you, and you know it's Him, you're sure it's Him, He brings it to pass. He doesn't let it fall by the wayside. He doesn't make you look like a liar. He brings it to pass. And when I say He did that when I was younger, well, you know, God has no time limits. It's our mindset. We think we're older, that we can't serve God anymore. We can't hear from God anymore. But I'm here to tell you this morning, God will always speak to you. If you've got your heart open, if you've got your mind open, you will hear from God, and He will bring it to pass. Whatever He tells you, He will bring it to pass.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We knew this girl years ago. She sang in this country music thing. They had these groups that used to come to our church all the time when we were down south. And she sang, and she was the lead singer. And she came down with cancer, and she got to the point of where she couldn't get out of bed anymore. She was just laying there waiting to die. But she loved the Lord. And as she was laying there one night, her band was playing somewhere nearby. And God told her, He said, get out of that bed. I didn't call you to do this. I called you to sing. So you get out and go sing praises for me. She said, Lord, I'm so weak I can't hardly get up. I don't know how I'll do this. And God said, get somebody to help you, but you get over there and sing for me. So she got her husband to help her get up and get dressed, and she was so weak he was almost carrying her. And they went on to the church, and well, everybody just went crazy when she walked in because they all knew she was dying. And she got up on the stage, and they had to prop her up. She couldn't stand up by herself, but she had one on one side of her and one on the other side propping her up. And she started singing. And the longer she sang, the stronger she got. And by the end of the night, she wasn't weak at all. They didn't have to hold her anymore. She was just walking around praising God. And she went back to the doctor and found out she didn't have cancer anymore. So it's a mindset. If we think we can't do something, we're never going to do it. We have to know we can do it. We have to be told by God sometimes that we can do it. God will still give me dreams and visions because He's a mighty God. He loves us. I'm just not looking for Him anymore because I've got that mindset. Well, I'm old now. I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to do that. But we can't get that mindset. We got to think young. And really, our mind never gets old. We always think young. We always feel young. No matter how old we get. And I'm not really that old. Hey, I know older. I know people who are older.
Just a moment.
Yeah, that's right. That's all it is. My mom was 82 when she died. And she was really healthy up until that point. And she was scared of death. So God took her quietly in her sleep. But she knew it was coming. She told my daughter that morning. She said, I'm going to die today. Now, my daughter never told me that until after it happened. I mean, if I had known, I could have spent the evening with her. I could have hugged her and told her I loved her. But Hope didn't tell me until it was too late, and she was gone. But she went quietly in her sleep. She didn't have to be afraid. God just took her. And I'm sure He sent angels to surround her. I know she was saved, so that made it easier when she left. But we moved up here 13 years ago, and that's when we met Joyce, when we first moved in. And my mama was living right across the street from Joyce, I think. And they had an ice storm that night, a real bad ice storm. And Gerald went over there, he brought my mama to our house, because we had a fireplace. All electricity was out. And Gerald wanted to shut the water off so the pipes wouldn't freeze up, but he didn't have nothing to do it with, so Josh gave him a wrench. Oh, they did? Shame on you.
Still got it?
You let the pipe bust. But anyway, my mom went on to be with the Lord that night. And, you know, I still miss her. I still think about her. 13 years is like nothing. It's nothing. If your mom is alive, treat her nice. I wish I had more time to treat my mama nice, but we took as good a care of her as we could at the end. But you know, the Lord is still with us, and he's still saying, Gerald made a prophecy to me one day that I was going to serve the Lord 10 more years. And when he said it, I thought, Lord, I don't know if I want to. 10 years, that's a long time. But I do want to, because whatever God's got for me, I want. And whatever he's got for y'all, he's going to give you if you just seek him. Keep your eyes and ears open and look for the Lord. One time he told me, he said, keep your eyes and your ears wide open. And I did. And I served him. And he just gave me so many great things. So many great things. I have to go back and read my book to remember them all. But God is speaking to somebody here today. Somebody's been going through some hard times, and they're just not sure what to do, how to serve the Lord anymore. But God wants to speak to you today, so you come on up as God leads.